Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the session of piano music by Afro-American composers. We're proud to introduce the artist for this session. Ms. Carol Stone is a graduate with a magna cum laude graduate of Fisk University. She's attended Indiana University, where she received a Master of Music degree with distinction, and also the coveted coveted performer certificate in piano. Carol is and completed the work for the Doctor of Music there in Indiana. Carol is currently an associate professor of piano at Tennessee State University, and we're proud to welcome her. Oh, David Walker. I am not doing fast. David Walker.
William Grant Still, John W. Work, and David M. Baker. Rob Simpson is currently chairman of the music department at Tennessee State University. He has composed music for organ, for piano and for piano and voice, piano and violin, for chorus and organ, and for band, and I may have left something out, but let you know that he is a composer of a very grouping. In 1959, he and Hazel Harrison were on the same faculty at Alabama State University, and she asked that he compose a piece for her based on a spiritual. He chose the spiritual, I got shoes, you got shoes, all got shoes, got shoes. He named it presentiment. Presentiment means the sense of something about to happen, a premonition.
Thank you.
it is said that when he visited the South for the first time, he was greatly impressed by Lane College's beautiful magnolia tree. So he composed this suite, which consists of five pieces. I will play two. The first one, which is entitled Magnolias, and the last one, which is entitled The Place Where the Rainbow Ends.
Thank you.
before I learned. And I thought every time I was teaching, I have to say. And as I looked over the rags in the big Scott Dunford book, it said, never play rags fast. It is wrong to play rags fast. And I kept trying to play it slow, and it just wouldn't do it. And finally, in that big volume, I found three rags that had a metronomic marking. Two of them were a quarter note to 100, and one was a quarter note to 72. And that's about what I played. Because I have a tendency to go back. Anyway, next is William Grant Still. William Grant Still, as you know, is known as the dean of Afro-American composers. I was privileged to have a copy of his seven traceries given to me by my former department head, Dr. Nicholas Lewis. And I just accepted it and kept it in my file for a long time. And finally, I decided I need to play some music by black composers. And I got the William Grant Still, the tracery. And I just set to the payoff. I said, this is no challenge, this is so easy. And I went and made my program. And I started playing the traceries. Now we are talking some freeform music. We're talking about key signatures that have nothing to do with the notes that he wrote. We are talking about one hand being on all the black keys and the other hand being on the white keys with a sharp here or there. That has nothing to do with the T signature that you have. And they're all, most of them, there are two that are slightly fast. But they have these horrendously slow tempo markers. I can't do this. So I went to Dr. Spencer, who is the authority on William Grant Still, since he did his doctoral dissertation on William Grant Still and his music. And I asked him, was Dr. Still crazy? And he assured me that, as we get older, we all have our idiosyncrasies, but he had never really thought of him as being crazy. And as I searched I finally ended up reading Dr. Simpson's dissertation. He told me I was probably the only one who read it. But I determined that Dr. Still was not going to whip me. And I read that dissertation. I read the biography by his wife, Verna Harvey. I listened to everything I could get my hands on about William Grant Still. Unfortunately, none of them were like the traceries, but it was enough to let me know that Dr. Still knew what he was doing and that he meant exactly what he said. Now, the traceries are impressionistic. They are mystical, they are mood pieces, and as I practice them more and more, I love them. They have become my favorite pieces. Now, I think I'm the only one who feels that way. So I'm only going to play three today. And this pains me. I'm very serious about this because I believe that the seventh make up a group that he had as a set. And I hate to break the set, but I haven't fully come to the conclusion that I'm going to use his quarter note equals 40 for most of his pieces. Yeah. Although, I'm still toying with the idea of whether this music was meant for concert performance or whether it was meant just to listen to at your own repose. But I'm going to work on this. You understand? I'm going to work on this, and I'm going to know what Dr. Steele meant, because I like these pieces. Now, a tracery, after I had worked with these for so long, I finally decided I didn't know what tracery was. So I looked it up in the dictionary, and I was surprised that it means a delicate interlacing network, like a Gothic window or fine embroidery. And what I think of mostly is spiderwebs, which have flexibility, yet they're very strong and they are perfectly made. So, Dr. Steele named each piece after it was composed. He was inspired by what the piece was and gave it a title. The first piece is Cloud Cradles. The third is Muted Laughter. And the fourth is Out of the Silence. Traceries.
Thank you. Thank you.
know David as a student at Indiana, and of course I didn't know he was somebody. I knew him as, I just met him. We were two or three of the few blacks who were there. And so we met, and on social occasions, I can remember one, don't tell my folks, but one particularly funky dance that David and I did at a party once. So I didn't know that he was somebody until I heard his jazz band, and I was completely floored. Yeah. Hello, Portia. Yes, it's good to see you again. And then when I heard some of his own compositions, I thought I'm in the presence of greatness, and I didn't even know it. Well, I was privileged to premiere his piano sonata somewhere in the 70s. And I think I was privileged because I just decided I was going to learn it. I think nobody else wanted to prove it. But I just decided I was going to do it. And during the time I was working on it and collaborating with David, he put the five short pieces for piano in my hand. And at that time, I was so sick of his music and all those ledger lines and all those cross rhythms. I didn't want to see, so they have sat in my file cabinet for years, and then I pulled them out last year. And I saw the second one was entitled to Bird, and I thought it was about tweet, tweet. And the first four bars weren't too difficult, and I thought, yeah, I can play that, and I turned to the next one, which was Passacaglia. Well, of course, everybody knows what Passacaglia is. And I saw the third one was, the fourth one really, was Evening Song, and it was slow. And the fourth one, Blues, the fifth one. See, I'm only playing four, there are five. I'm not playing the first one. The fifth one, Blues Waltz, parentheses, neat, terrible, teeth, close parentheses. Well, after I committed myself to learn the pieces, I thought, oh, no, I'm in over my head again. So, all right, I talked to our, you know how fine our jazz band is. Ben Kirk, the director, I have utmost respect for. So I went to Ben, and Ben informed me of Charlie Parker. I couldn't find the Passacaglia until he showed me where it was. I finally asked David about the Blues Waltz, which he has indicated moderato. So I said, quarter note to 88. And he said, quarter note to 152. And we are talking about one hand in 6/4 and the other hand, no, 4/4, 6/4, and no quarter notes. Well, anyway, I'm going to, for time's sake, I'm going to pray with you. I'm going to play Bird, Passacaglia, Evening Song, and Blues Waltz, which is supposed to sound like, I think, the longest song. Thank you.
Thank you.
I would like to tell you, for those of you who do not play David's piano music, that all of those notes are written out. There's no improvisation.
I had to learn every blowing note.
I hope you, we started just a little bit late, and I'd like to play this last piece that was written for me by my department head, Ralph Simpson. It is called Impromptu. Ralph and I go back a long way. I like to say when I was this high and he was that high. But he told me in 1979 that he was going to write a piece for me. And I was very honored and flattered. And I said, oh, good. And so he sat me down and he said, what sort of things don't you like? And I said, well, I hate optics. And I said, I don't like these things with leaps in it. And something said, be quiet. So I shut up. And I'm glad I did, because you know this piece is full of leaps and optics. Impromptu, 1979.
Thank you.
this performance is that to them?
Well,
I know I speak for everyone.